हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ द एसडीएसएम कॉलेज पालघर। आई एम विलास सर एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अ न्यू टॉपिक रिगार्डिंग द सेम चैप्टर इरिगेशन मैनेजमेंट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ड्रेनेज, देयर मीनिंग, इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ ड्रेनेज, विच आर द कॉजेस ऑफ इम्प्रॉपर ड्रेनेज, what are the remedies for drainage improvement, subsurface drainage or underground drainage. Next topic, it is a watershed management, the definition part, which are the types of the watershed, objectives of watershed management, component of watershed management, what are the steps in watershed management, and lastly we'll discuss about the water harvesting. In generally, drainage is the system or the process by which the water or the other liquid are drained from the place. The lines of the ports with the pebbles to ensure that the good drainage is required, and the drainage system has to collapse because of the too much rainfall. So drainage is important in the farming point of view, so farmers take care of it. In the farm area, the excess soil moisture or the water lodging occurs due to the heavy or the continuous rainfall, and due to the faulty irrigation practice it may be happens. So water lodging causes the several changes in the soil, and the planting results in the reduced growth of crops, and hence some cases or the death of the plants may be faced. The proper drainage is the removal of the excess gravitational water from the soil by the artificial techniques in the crop production. In drainage, the provision of the suitable method for the removal of excess irrigation or the rainfall water from the field area is to be facilitated for the favorable moisture condition and the for the growth of plants. So it should be removed at certain period of time. Let's see the importance of a drainage. In the subsurface drainage system or any type of a drainage system, it is mainly irrigated area, and hence they are in the humid areas. A drainage system is to be needed on a irrigated land to control the water table, and that ensures the water will be able to move from the soil. Thus, it keeps the salt from the accumulating in the root zone and making soil unproductive. Let's see the various advantages of a good drainage. The field will not get waterlogged, and the crop can get sufficient water and air. The soil comes in a proper tilt earlier after the rainfall, and it is possible to carry out the agricultural operations in proper time. Good drainage helps to improve the physical structure of the soil, and the proper drainage prevents salt accumulation and degradation of irrigated lands. Next, maybe it should be good balanced among the moisture, air and the temperature at the root zone. And lastly, microbial activity should be induced and resulted in the accelerated organic matter decomposition. Let's see the which are the causes of improper drainage. Sometimes the soil will not well drained, so there will be a water lodging or the stagnation of a water takes place, and it affects the growth and the yield of crops, and it causes such bad and improper drainage. Let's see which are they. If the soil is fine textured in such a way, clay with poor permeability or the water can easily pass through the soil, can not move downwards fast enough, एंड इट अकोमुलेट्स ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द थीन लेयर ऑफ ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिंग एरेशन. नेक्स्ट विल बी वाटर टेबल मे बी अ हाई एंड एडिशनल ग्रेविटेशनल वाटर अकोमुलेट्स एंड इट चोक्स द एयर स्पेसेस एंड इट सैचुरेट्स एट द सर्फेस और द सब सॉइल लेयर. देर मे बी अ सॉल्ट अफेक्टिंग वाटर एब्जॉर्प्शन बाय द रूट्स. नेक्स्ट मे बी ड्यू टू द लो लेइंग एरिया एक्सेस रेनफॉल और द रेन वाटर कैन नॉट बी कैरिड आउट एज सरफेस रन ऑफ रैपिडली थ्रू द ड्रेनेज. नेक्स्ट द फॉल्टी यूज ऑफ इरीगेशन वाटर लीड्स टू बी क्रिएशन ऑफ अ वाटर लॉजिंग कंडीशन एंड इट रेज द ग्राउंड वाटर टेबल. Next, the humid region with the continuous and the heavy rainfall raises water table and it saturates at the pore surface spaces. And lastly, the area under the saline, alkaline or the salty soil area with a poor permeability. So these may be affecting largely because the improper drainage leads to the various bad effects in the field area. Let's see what are the remedies for a drainage improvement. There are few landscape practice we can use to improve the poorly drained soil. So we can grow a larger variety of crops for various seasonal crops. Let's see the first, it is a surface drainage. It is the simplest and the common method practiced in India, and this method is largely outlet channel or the filled ditches on the formed on surface to improve their excess water due to the heavy rainfall or over irrigation area. The irrigation channel is also serves the drainage channel. It may be flowed from any canals, river water or any type of a channel. They are providing our enough water. So these drains cause hindrance to field preparation and intercultivation area. They are subjected to the silting or the weeding growth, which are to be removed at a regular time. Open drain are damaged by the rodents or any animal which are living at the nearer the farm area. Different methods are applied for the surface drainage on the specific land, soil characteristics and crop grown area. Let's see first random fill ditches. It is the shallow depth are formed randomly over the field and the depressions are connected by the means of shallow channels. Next is land smoothening. In this method, the elevated area is cut off and the excess soil is spread over low area so that the surface will be evenly or uniformly at the slope area. The excess surface runoff is collected and conveyed into the field ditches to provide the lower head. Next is bending technique. The small furrows are formed at a known interval at parallel to the slope of drainage out water. Next is parallel field ditches. It is similar to the bending technique, but ditches are made at a parallel level of the greater capacity are formed instead of the dead furrows. And this is let's see the subsurface drainage or the underground drainage. In this drainage system, it avoids the wastage of land and do not interfere with the farm area operation area. So let's take the first one. It is a tile drainage. It consists of digging a narrow trench और प्लेसिंग शॉर्ट सेक्शन ऑफ टाइल्स एट द बॉटम लेवल एंड द कवरिंग टाइल्स विद द अर्थ. नेक्स्ट इट इज अ रबल ड्रेन. द कटिंग ऑफ नैरो वी शेप ड्रेन और द रेक्टेंगुलर सेक्शंस एज फॉर द बॉक्स ड्रेन्स एंड इट फिल्स विद द रफ स्टोन. द लार्ज और द स्मॉल स्टोन्स आर कवर्ड विद द होल एंड द सॉइल लेवल विद द सरफेस ऑफ फील्ड सॉइल. इट मे बी रेंजेस एट द 90 सेंटीमीटर इन डेप्थ. नेक्स्ट इज द परफोरेटेड पाइप ड्रेन्स. इन दिस टेक्निक द परफोरेटेड पाइप इज डिजाइन टू अलाउ द वॉटर टू एक्सटेंड एंड इट एग्जिस्ट थ्रू द स्मॉल होल अलॉन्ग विद द पाइप. एज यू कैन सी द पिक्चर्स ऑफ अ सबसरफेस ड्रेनेज, टाइल ड्रेनेज एंड द परफोरेटेड पाइप ड्रेनेज. लेट्स सी द वॉटरशेड मैनेजमेंट. वॉटरशेड मैनेजमेंट इट इज़ अ स्टडी ऑफ अ रेलिवेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ वॉटरशेड एम्ड एट सस्टेनेबल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ इट्स रिसोर्सेज एंड एम द प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ क्रिएटिंग एंड इम्प्लीमेंटिंग प्लान्स प्रोग्राम्स एंड प्रोजेक्ट टू सस्टेन एंड एनहांस द वॉटरशेड फंक्शंस ऑफ अवर क्रॉप एरिया. मेन एम ऑफ और द पर्पज ऑफ द वॉटरशेड मे बी अ लैंड एरिया दैट ड्रेन्स टू स्ट्रीम लेक रिवर और कैनल. इट अफेक्ट्स द वॉटर क्वालिटी इन द वॉटर बॉडी एंड दैट सराउंड्स एट. द हेल्दी वॉटरशेड नॉट ओनली हेल्प्स टू प्रोटेक्ट वॉटर क्वालिटी बट इट ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड द ग्रेटर बेनिफिट्स एंड डिग्रेड द वॉटरशेड टू द पीपल्स farms and animals to live there. Let's see the types of watershed as per the different category based on size, drainage and the shape and land. The patterns may be first on the basis of the area. That may be mini watershed. It ranges or covers 1 to 100 hectares area. Second one is a micro watershed. It ranges 100 to 1000 hectare per area. Third be milli watershed. It ranges 1000 to 10,000 hectare per area. Sub watershed. It ranges 10,000 hectare to 50,000 hectare per area. Macro watershed area. It is a more than 50,000 per hectare. So on the basis of shape, they may be categorized into square, rectangular, triangular, oval, fern leaf shape, palm shape, polygon shape, circular. Let's see the objectives of watershed management. To control the damaging runoff of the water area and the degradation and thereby conservation of the soil and water is necessary. To promote the sustainable farming and stabilize crop yielding by adopting suitable cropping or the crop management system. Next may be to check the soil erosion and increase the water infiltration rate. Next is to cover the non-arable area or effective way of air passing from the soil. It necessary afforestation and pasture land. Next may be to restore ecological balance. Next, to enhance the income of the individual by adopting alternate enterprises. Next may be to minimize the risk of flood, drought and the landslide area. And lastly, to supply or securing of clean and sufficient drinking water. Let's see the component of watershed management. There will be a 4 different components are established. First is the soil water conservation. In that, the soil and the water conservation is to be checked soil erosion and it increase the availability of the groundwater. Temporary method, moderate method, एंड परमानेंट मेथड इज टू बी अप्लाइड इन टेम्पररी मेथड द कल्टिवेशन प्रैक्टिस अक्रॉस द स्लोप एरिया इट इज टू रिक्वायर्ड एज पर द टाइम टू टाइम रिनोवेशन इन मॉडरेट मेथड देर हैविंग द लेवलिंग ऑफ द लैंड 4 to 5 meters एंड द बर्न्स आर मेड एट द स्पीड ऑफ वाटर फ्लो एरिया नेक्स्ट इज इट इज द परमानेंट मेथड इन दैट द सॉइल इरोजन एंड द स्लो डाउन स्पीडी वाटर फ्लो इट इज टू बी प्रोटेक्टेड फॉर द चेक ऑफ डैम्स पर्कुलेशन एंड द पॉन्ड एरिया नेक्स्ट इट इज अ वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग द अकोमोलेशन एंड द स्टोरेज ऑफ रेन वाटर इज टू बी रियूज ऑन द साइट एंड रैदर दैन अलोइंग द रन ऑफ द वाटर इज कलेक्टेड इन द फार्म पॉन्ड इट इज मे बी आर्टिफिशियल पॉन्ड एंड द पर्कुलेटेड और द पर्कुलेशन टैंक्स नालाज एंड डीप टैंक्स फॉर द डोमेस्टिक यूज Next, it is a water harvesting. The water harvesting, it is a general term, refers for the collection of a rainstorm generated runoff from the particular area. And it provides the water for the humans, animals, and for the crop growth. So, why the harvesting water is necessary? It allows the collection of the large amount of water and it required or it can be used at the drought period the most necessary platform for the collecting water of a rainfall it is mostly free from the harmful chemicals and it makes suitable for a irrigation purpose or the farm purpose importance of water harvesting let's see rain water harvesting It is one of the most effective method and the water is managed in the proper way and it is conserved. The term it used to indicate the collection or the storage of rainwater for humans, animals and plant. And it involves the collection of the rainfall water and the surf surface before it lost. Next it is the groundwater harvesting. It is an artificial one. The groundwater or it is preserved at the ground level or the groundwater reservoir. The augmented at the rate of exceeding at the natural condition. Lastly, roof water harvesting. The technique through which the rainwater is captured from the roof catchment and it's stored in the reservoir. It is artificially man-made. It can be stored in the surface or the subsurface area by adopting artificial recharge techniques. It helps the self-sufficiency of water supply and it reduces the cost of pumping, providing high quality water. And many more that is the very much soft and low minerals are trapped and less expensive in use let's have the look of the pictures of roof water surface as well as the water harvesting from the farm areas I hope you may have understood the today's topic We have discussed about the drainage and the watershed management, how we can improve the quality of crops and we can irrigate proper way without any drainage. So if you have any queries or doubts, you can comment in the CP group एंड यू कैन पर्सनली यू कैन आस्क. सो टिल देन द कंप्लीटेड चैप्टर एंड वी विल कम अप विद द न्यू चैप्टर्स इन नेचर. सो टिल देन थैंक यू.